What to Play presents the 15 most anticipated VR games for 2021, arranged by release dates. Visit our website at whattoplay.com to see the full list of all upcoming virtual reality titles. Link in the description box below. Hitman 3. An unexpected announcement for the Hitman fans. The final chapter of the world's greatest assassin is now fully playable in virtual reality. Not only that, all three Hitman titles are now rebuilt to support VR. That means all 20 or more locations across all three games can now be explored and experienced in an entirely new way. It's set to release this January 2021 exclusively for the PlayStation VR. Panzer Dragoon Voyage Record. A remnant of a bygone era of rail shooters makes a return in virtual reality. Sega's Panzer Dragoon series once won the hearts of players during the 90s, and now they get to relive the experience once again in this dramatic VR shooter. The reveal trailer showcased the new yet familiar gameplay of the franchise, and surprisingly, Voyage Record will be a compilation of their three titles, namely Panzer Dragoon, Panzer Dragoon Zwei, and RPG Panzer Dragoon Saga. It's still in development and is assumed to come out next year for the PC, PS4, and select VR devices. Wraith, The Oblivion, Afterlife. When it comes to VR, the horror genre is a canvas of infinite possibilities. Fast Travel Games Project lets players become an object of horror itself. As a wraith, they navigate a twisted mansion devoid of pure souls. Players will use a variety of spectral abilities to solve puzzles and unlock the secrets hidden behind its walls. The game is set within the World of Darkness universe. Despite its terrifying elements, it is narrative-driven with focus on exploration and stealth in a first-person perspective. Its doors will open this early 2021 for the PC and PS4. After the Fall. Also pushing VR to its potential is Vertigo Games' upcoming IP. From the makers of Arizona Sunshine comes an adrenaline-pumping co-op FPS set 20 years into the future. After the Fall pits up to 4 players into a living, breathing world full of doom and gloom. Using VR, coordinate with other players and thwart a legion of infected monsters from taking over this frozen wasteland. Customize loadouts and find the perfect mod for some massive firepower. Coming this early 2021 for the PC. Phasmophobia. The latest gaming phenomenon that dominated the gaming charts. Just in time for Spooktober, this first-person virtual reality game from Kinetic Games is not just a test of patience, but friendship as well. As a group of amateur paranormal investigators enter decrepit zones teeming with abnormal supernatural energy. The main objective is to document as much paranormal activity as possible without costing the lives of the crew.
Oh, the dark!
We're dead.
That was a teddy bear.
Open the fucking door!
Stop fucking! Jesus!
That means communicating with the dead and placing cameras in strategic locations. It's still in its early access phase, which means there's still more content coming once the game officially releases next year for the PC.
No one is safe. The fear they can instill in a foe, it can penetrate the soul.
Sniper Elite VR. When the third-person gameplay of Rebellion's acclaimed sniper game doesn't feel enough, then this virtual reality version might do the trick. Much like the previous entries, players assume the role of a master marksman determined to topple a fascist empire to the ground by popping their heads in satisfying X-ray kill shots. It's pretty straightforward, but the joy comes with planning the perfect execution from its long list of targets. It's set to release sometime next year. Space Engine. Space enthusiasts can finally enjoy the stars at the comfort of their own home in this virtual reality title from Vladimir Romaniuk. Manipulate all of time and space using the laws of physics and most importantly, with VR gear. It's a realistic planetarium designed to teach would-be scientists on how the universe works. It may be theoretical most of the time, but the endless possibilities of witnessing these moving bodies are a joy to behold. It's currently on Steam's early access for quite some time now, but is planning to come out next year. Myst. A full-fledged remake of the 1993 point-and-click classic, developer Cyan takes players once again into the surrealistic island full of vibrant flora and fauna. Now, as a VR title, the original game's atmosphere is amplified for even greater immersion. Enjoy its breathtaking sights now with improved visuals and better sound for that perfect escape from reality. There's not much details as of the moment, but the game is coming out to the PC next year. The Mighty Eighth, an upcoming war game from the developers of classic simulation titles from the 80s and 90s. Take control of iconic warplanes such as B-17s and ME-109s, all recreated with meticulous detail. MicroProse's ambitious leap into VR territory puts players into the cockpit, along with 10 others, in cooperative bombing missions set during the height of World War II. For non-VR players, the game is fully playable without donning that expensive headgear. It's set to release sometime next year. Blunt Force. Speaking of World War II, another VR title set during history's darkest era is coming next year for the PC. The game promises a rich story with an action-packed campaign focusing on two simultaneous storylines. It is loaded with epic set pieces that could rival AAA titles, except this one has virtual reality plastered all over. It's part shooter, part arcade fun, which gives players the choice to go guns blazing or enjoy simple shooting challenges. My duty was to fight. The Soul Keeper Chronicles. There's no denying that virtual reality still has untapped potential, and this ambitious RPG from Helm Systems might be scratching its surface. Set in a dark fantasy world, players embark in unique open-world scenarios spanning from three different single-player campaigns. They can also decide whether they want to play with or without VR. It's still in early development, so what we're seeing right now is subject to change. Who knows what the endgame product would look like? It's slated for a 2021 release. Project Wingman. The combat flight action game is nothing new these days, but Sector D2's upcoming VR title looks promising. Instead of using standard World War II warplanes, Project Wingman takes us into an alternate future where dogfights have left most of the mark in the world. With a selection of supersonic jet planes and more, each of these flying metallic monsters is equipped with their own futuristic weaponry. The game is still in development and it's scheduled to release next year. Firmament. Cyan Studios' upcoming VR title is as ambitious as the rest of their catalog. It's set within the Cyan's shared Myst universe, and as usual, it's brimming with rich atmosphere. Unlike their previous titles where players travel alone, Firmament introduces a little clockwork companion on their journey. Work together to unlock the secrets of this mysterious new world. The game is far from finished, and its Kickstarter campaign is in need of more support. It's expected to come out this 2022, but the devs remain optimistic for a 2021 release.
Oh, hey there. Have you ever thought of pursuing an exciting career in extracurricular law enforcement?
Sam and Max, this time it's virtual. The classic crime-fighting duo is making a comeback as a virtual reality game. It's the perfect platform for the comedic adventures of these anthropomorphic characters, especially now that most quirky titles from the days of old fare better in virtual reality. There's still not enough details to report as of the moment, and it's been a while since players enjoyed a Sam and Max title. It's slated for a 2021 release.
Behind every brilliant invention, there hides a brilliant inventor.
Tin Hearts. An early access title since 2018, this adorable VR game is built for simplicity and fun. Guide a squad of tin soldiers in a miniature toy world. Control the environment around them to make their journey easier. Watch them as they march their way to new platforms and charming puzzle encounters. It's a game built for little kids or anyone who wants to relax after a long day of work. It's expected to officially release next year for the PC, but that's always subject to change.